Two investigations are underway tonight into the death of Jeffrey Epstein. The Justice Department and the FBI are sifting through information about the wealthy financier and the associates who allegedly helped him traffic underage girls. White House correspondent Mark Irons brings us the latest. Mark?
Wyatt, we are learning tonight two of the jail guards assigned to watch Epstein around the time of his death have been placed on leave, and the warden has been temporarily reassigned. Now, this announcement comes as mounting evidence grows against this correctional facility. President Trump says he supports a thorough probe.
I want a full investigation, and that's what I absolutely am demanding.
People familiar with the jail where Epstein was being held say it was understaffed, and one of the guards was not a regular correctional officer. Attorney General William Barr says Epstein's death won't stop the investigation into his alleged crimes.
Let me assure you that this case will continue on against anyone who was complicit with Epstein. Any co-conspirators should not rest easy.
The reporter who initially broke the story says Epstein had enablers, and there's more to uncover.
The threads of this sex trafficking case are far wider than Epstein. He had a lot of help doing this. He did not do this himself. A lot of people made money off of this operation.
Yesterday, FBI agents raided Epstein's private island in the Caribbean.
That was not a good place, as I understand it, and I was never there. So you have to ask, did Bill Clinton go to the island? That's the question. If you find that out, you're going to know a lot.
Epstein had connections to both Clinton and Trump. And today, the president said he had no idea if the Clintons were involved in Epstein's death. His remarks came after retweeting a conspiracy theory this weekend that alleged a connection.
Donald Trump met Jeffrey Epstein in the late 80s, and they socialized at parties over the years. Now, last month, President Trump said he hadn't spoken to Epstein in 15 years, and he went on to say he was not a fan of Jeffrey Epstein. Wyatt.
White House correspondent Mark Irons reporting. Thanks, Mark.